to fight any super middleweight, but then you get a phone call and it's Canelo Alvarez wants to fight you. Like, well, okay, man, let's do it.
This is a big, Rocky, huge rest for Canelo.
First things first, man. Welcome to America.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Now, this fight with Canelo, what's the weight limit on this fight? What do you guys got to be on the scale?
Fight weight, 12 stone.
Was that in pounds?
6'8".
Yeah. Rocky, this is a huge rest for Canelo. Him moving up 8 pounds to super middleweight. How confident? What makes you think that he's confident he's going to beat you fight night?
It's 8 pounds, and I don't think he's going to put 8 pounds of muscle on or anything like that in the next week's time. Do you know what I mean? So I make the weight comfortable and I'm big at the weight. You know, he's coming up. I don't think he's the biggest at middleweight. He's definitely not nowhere near as big as super middleweight. So it's a challenge, like he said, it's a challenge for him. It's a massive challenge for me. He's an elite fighter. He's the ninth pound. He's a number face of boxer. And you know what? It's a challenge for me. So you want to be the best, you got to fight the best. And this is where I'm at.
Have you ever been to the Garden or?
Yeah, well, it's a little story. I was here 3 years ago with my girlfriend. We did like a tour around Madison Square Garden.
Oh, really?
Went to the Knicks game.
You did?
I was just in the top tier, just looking around saying, you know, I'd love to imagine fighting here, like things like that. And then, you know, we went outside, got a picture took outside, I posted on Instagram saying, you know, hashtag one day. Thinking nothing, just, you know, as you do. And, you know, 3 years later, I get the phone call to find the biggest star in boxing.
That's cool.
So, yeah. It's great. It's unbelievable.
Rocky, what's the plan? You could budge, you could brawl. Do you think he will bring the fight to you? Like, he'll go in and fight in? Or what's your plan?
I don't know. I've got to see how it goes. He's a very experienced fighter. Do you know what they're doing? I've got a very good team behind me in trainer. Who's guiding me to win this title. I've just got to use... Well, I can use the best I can. I can mix it, I can fight, I'm heavy handed, I can punch. So, I've got to use my strengths.
Do you think you have the advantages being the natural bigger guy and taller?
In some ways, yeah, obviously, yeah. The height, the reach, and naturally at the weight. I know he's a elite.
How big of an impact do you think that'll be fight night for you? The height and reach, how big of an impact do you think that would be?
Off the face off there, there's some height there on me, so I'm just going to use it to the advantage.
Rocky, you're on a 6-fight winning streak. What are you going to bring to the table with those 6 wins coming into the biggest fight of your career?
The biggest fight in them 6 was winning this world title. It was a travel to Germany that no one gave me a chance. I fought an unbeaten fighter. It was his 4th, 5th defense of the title. He was supposed to be the next big star in Germany, and I went over there very confident. And I always said that if I fight that next level opponent, it brings the best out of me, and that's what it did on the night. And I'm taking everything from that fight and more into this fight. And I want to strip the Madison Square Garden, the big Canelo, the big thing. I was going to strip it all down and focus on just me and Canelo to fight it out.
Is there going to be any changes in changing camp? In training camp, excuse me?
No. Every camp has been the same and it's worked so far. Even my last fight, the camp went perfect. So there'll be no changes. I'll put myself through some tough days. I know where I know I'm gonna have to dig deep and stuff, but I won't be going away to train away and not like that. I'll just be staying at home and getting the work done.
Now, Canelo's looking to be
in the middle, please. Some questions from the middle.
Rocky, any takeaways from the last two fights with Canelo's last two fights with Triple G?
I think he boxed brilliant the last fight. I don't know what he put himself through camp, and then he's having a couple of weeks off, then he's going to go back into the 10-week camp, and the cuts he's had and stuff like that. It's going to be interesting to see how it all goes. But I know he's an athlete and he's a elite fighter, so I thought he nipped the fight as well. He was close, he looked well, so I'm looking forward to the night.
What are your thoughts on how he took Triple G's power in the second fight? And how do you think that'll translate with him moving up fighting?
He took some good shots away. I know he can take shots. It's a solid fighter. The weight is I don't know on the night, it depends on how the shots land and how it is. So that's why it's interesting to see him stepping up and challenging him, you know, for myself challenging him.
Rocky, what would a victory?